We are discussing about light reflection and refraction. Laws of reflection. This laws of reflection has one point, which is angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. If this is a plane, this is the normal to the plane. If a ray comes here, if this is the angle of inclination, or you can say angle of incidence, then if this ray reflects, say some angle R is there, so I should be equal to R. Angle of incidence should be equal to angle of reflection. Then this incident ray, second one is incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal ray, this normal to this plane, all lie 1, 2, 3, this all 1, 2, 3 lie on the same plane. So these are the laws of reflection. Spherical mirrors. What are spherical mirrors? Most common type of curved mirrors, these are spherical mirrors. Mirrors in which the reflecting surface are spherical in shape, these are called spherical mirrors because of their shape. And reflective surface of a mirror, this can be curved inwards, it can be curved inwards or curved outwards. So, because it can be like this, so it can be curved inwards or curved outwards. The one which is curved inward is known as concave mirror. This is known as concave mirror. And the one which is curved outwards, this is known as convex mirror. So these are both called as spherical mirrors. Some important terms with respect to reflection and refraction, like what is pole, principal axis, center of curvature, aperture, principal focus. Pole. What is a pole? The center of the reflecting surface, the center of the reflecting surface in a spherical mirror is a pole. In this figure, this P is a pole. This P is a pole. What is center of curvature? Reflecting surface in a spherical mirror has a center. And this is known as center of curvature. If this is your curve, then center of curvature in this convex mirror, it lies, if it is a convex mirror, it lies behind the mirror. It lies behind the mirror. But if it is concave, then it lies in front of the mirror, like this. So this is the center of curvature for this concave mirror, Then radius of curvature. What is the radius of curvature? See, this is a part of a circle. This is a part of a circle. So you can make a circle out of it. Here also you can make a circle. This is a circle. So there has to be some center. So the radius of this reflecting surface of this spherical mirror is known as radius of curvature. So this center is radius of curvature. And this, in this case, in this figure, for this concave mirror, the radius of curvature is R, capital R here, right? This is radius of curvature. And principal axis. What is the principal axis? See this, let me show you. From this point to this point, this is R. This we are talking about the radius of curvature. Now what is the principal axis? The straight line which is passing through the pole and the center of curvature. So this is the center of curvature and this is the pole. So center of curvature is here, pole is here. There is a line which is passing, and the line which is passing, a straight line which is passing through the pole and the center of curvature. In this case, you can call it for both the mirrors, concave, convex, that is spherical mirror. This is known as the principal axis. So this is your principal axis. Here in this case, this dotted black line or the this line is called as principal axis. What is principal focus? What is the principal focus here? The reflected ray appear to come from a point on the principal axis. The reflected ray appear to come from a point on the principal axis. So this is known as the principal focus. In this case, this point is a principal focus because the reflected ray appear to come from this point on the principal axis. We'll know about this more, but for the time being, this is your principal focus. Focal length. A focal length is the distance from the pole, this pole in a spherical mirror, to the focal as is a to what? From pole to principal focus. We just knew that this is principal focus and this is the pole. So if this is a pole and this is principal focus, say F, the distance between these two is known as the focal length, and this is represented by F. Then aperture. What is the aperture? The diameter of the reflecting surface is known as aperture. The diameter, see, this is a diameter. So because this is a diameter, the radius of curvature is twice the focal length. Radius of curvature is twice the focal length. The diameter of the reflecting surface is defined as the aperture. So aperture is basically the diameter of the reflecting surface. And as I just suggested, the radius of curvature is twice the focal length. How do we represent the images formed by a spherical mirror using ray diagrams? So these rays you can make like this, how does we represent them? So we draw the ray diagram in order to locate the image of an object being formed, where the image will be formed because of a convex or a concave mirror. So the intersection point of at least two reflected rays, that means there has to be two reflected rays. If let me take an example, this gives this intersection will give you the position of the image of that point object, and these two rays can be used to draw the ray diagram. That is, you can take a parallel, or this is a principal axis. You can take a ray parallel to principal axis. If it is parallel, it should pass through the focus after reflection. So if there is a parallel ray which is parallel to the principal axis, it will pass through the focus. So when it hits this or come in contact with this spherical mirror, which in this case is a concave mirror, this will change the direction and it will pass through the focus this way, okay, after reflection. Or in the case of a convex mirror, if it is convex mirror, then when it hits like this, then it appears to diverge in the case of convex mirror. The first case for a concave mirror, the ray parallel to the principal axis should pass through focus. And in this case, when it hits, say it is reflecting like this. So we can say that it is, we can extend it. The angle of incidence is equal to an angle of reflection. So where this is reflected, we can extend it, and when it is extended, it passes through focus. So both ways it passes through, it appears to pass through focus, here it actually passes through focus. And then when you join this, you can just join this C, then you will see that I equal to R, that is why it is passing through focus. a ray which is passing through the focus, if this is a ray, now it is coming, it is passing through this focus, this is a focus of the concave mirror, or in the case of a convex mirror, if, because in both the case, it should appear parallel to the principal axis after reflection. So if it is coming like this and it is passing through focus, whenever it reflects, it has to be parallel to the principal axis. In this case also, when it reflects like this, and if it is passing through some focus, if I am saying that if it is passing through some focus, then it has to be parallel to principal axis. It has to be parallel to principal axis. So when it is coming like this, and if we extend it, if it is supposed to pass through focus, then when it reflects, it should be parallel to this principal axis. A ray which is passing through the center of curvature, if this is passing through center of curvature in the concave mirror, or you can say directed in case of convex mirror, it should reflect along the same path. That means if it is passing through the center of curvature and if it hits, it will take the same path and it will go back, or it will reflect along the same path. In the same case, if it goes like this and it appears to pass through C, it has to reflect in the same way or same manner. Right? Then a ray when incident obliquely to principal axis. Say if there is a ray and it is incident obliquely, say with some angle I on a concave, it should be reflected obliquely only like this. You just have to see that angle of incidence should be angle of reflection. So this is oblique. Similarly, in this case also, it should be reflected in similar manner. I should be equal to R. Formation of image by convex mirror. Convex mirror. So the image which convex mirror make, or image formed in a convex mirror, is always virtual and erect. Whichever is the position of the object, wherever you place it, will always be virtual and erect. So what are the types of images formed by convex mirror? First case is when the object is placed at infinity. So when, say, an object is placed at infinity, say two rays, here we have A and D, this ray, and BE, you say this is B and this is E. So these two rays, they run parallel to the principal axis, this principal axis, and they will get diverged in the direction of DG and EH. How? See, this will reflect and we are going to extend it. It appears to be coming from F. Again, this BE, it reflects and it appears to come from F. So in both the cases, they are diverged, or they will be diverged in the direction DG and EH. And when the diverged ray, if we extend them backwards, they appear to intersect at the principal focus. Therefore, in convex mirror, this is a convex mirror, if the object is present or placed at infinity, then the image is formed behind the mirror. If this is front, this is the behind part. At the principal focus, this is the principal focus, and it's very, very small, highly diminished, but it's virtual and erect. When the object is placed anywhere between the pole and the infinity, then if this is infinity and this is pole, we are placing the object somewhere here in between this. Say this ray starting from A and which is running parallel to the principal axis, this will get reflected along dx direction. So let us extend it on backwards, right? So it will appear because it is parallel, it will appear that it is coming from the focus. So this comes from focus. There is another ray which is AE, this AE, and on this AE from A of the object, it will go towards the center of curvature. See, it goes towards the center of curvature. Now this extended ray and this extended backward extended ray, they intersect at this point. So this is A dash, this is B dash. So these two reflected ray, this is dx, this dx and ea are diverging rays and appear to intersect each other at point A dash when we produce it back. So in this case, the image is formed behind the mirror, again behind the mirror, between the pole and the principal focus, pole and the principal focus, which is again diminished, means of the smaller size than AB, and also erect, means it is not like this, so it is erect, and virtual, because it is being made by dotted lines produced backwards. So what can we conclude, the summary of images which is formed by convex mirror is, the position of the object, if it is at infinity, the position of the image will be at focus and behind the mirror. Size of the image will be highly diminished, virtual and erect. Between the infinity and the pole, it will be between P, this P and F, focus, focal point, behind the mirror. Diminished, not highly diminished, but diminished, of that is the lesser size than the original image or the object. And it is also virtual and erect in both the cases. So where are these convex mirror being used? They are used as rear view mirrors. They are used to see the traffic behind. They are preferred as they get erect, right? They are getting erect image, but diminished image. What are the sign conventions for reflection by the mirrors, convex and concave mirrors? So a new Cartesian sign convention is being applied, or we will use it for solving the problem for spherical mirror. The convention is like this. The object is always placed to the left. If this is the mirror, this is left side, this is right side. So object will always be placed on the left. All distance which are parallel to the principal axis are measured from the pole of the mirror. From the pole of the mirror. All the distance measured to the right of the origin along axis, these are taken as positive. The distance towards this right, they are taken as positive. While those measured to the left of the origin, that is left of the origin, this way, they will be taken as negative. Distance which are measured perpendicular and above the principal axis, like this, above and perpendicular to the principal axis, that is along y-axis, positive y-axis, these are taken as positive. Distances measured perpendicular and below the principal axis, like this, these are taken as negative. So this is the sign convention for reflection by spherical mirrors. What is the mirror formula and magnification? If you see this diagram, the distance of the object from its pole is known as object distance. Means from this is u. The distance of the object from its pole. While the distance from the pole of the mirror is known as, or pole of the mirror is known as V, that is the this image being formed. So this is U. Okay, you have to take proper signing convention. So the formula will be 1 by F will be equal to 1 by V plus 1 by U. So the image distance, the object distance, the image distance, and this is the focal length. And this is applicable for a spherical mirror in all position of the object. What is the magnification? That is, it can be defined as relative extent to which the object is magnified in comparison to its object size. That means if the image size h, the height of the image is hi, this is I sub is used for image, and the object is ho, then magnification is hi by ho. You can also write it as v by u, and m is the magnification, ho is the height of the object, hi is the height of the image. So it is to be taken as negative. Why? For real images. For real images, a negative sign just means a negative sign in the value of magnification. That, see, that means the image is real. The nature of the image is real. And the positive sign in the value of the magnification will indicate the virtual image. Real means negative. Positive means virtual image. Refraction of light. So whenever a light passes through some medium, it bends. It bends. So bending of light rays as it passes from one medium to another medium is known as refraction of light. So what are the laws of refraction? The incident ray, refracted ray and normal ray lie in the same plane. Say, this is medium 1, this is medium 2. So whenever a ray enters another medium, it will not go in the same path. Rather, it will bend somewhat. So it is going to bend. So the incident ray, this I, the reflected ray, this R, refracted ray, and this normal, this one, they all lie in the same plane. And this is the, say this is the angle I, this is the refraction angle R. So there is a relation. The ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is always constant. And this law is known as Snell's law of refraction. Okay. We'll know what this constant will be in the refractive index. So refractive index, what is a refractive index? When a light passes from one medium to another medium, it will be refracted. That is, it is going to change its direction or its course. So the extent to which the direction will change can be expressed in terms of refractive index. And this refractive index, the value of this refractive index is dependent on the speed of the light in two medium. That means, this is medium 1, this is medium 2, and this gets refracted. So speed of light in medium 1, speed of light in medium 2, the refractive index, that is, if you call it as mu, say. So it is dependent on the speed on these two medium. Let us suppose that V1 is the speed of the light medium, light in medium 1. V2 is the speed of light in medium 2. So what is the refractive index of medium 2 with respect to 1? N21 we write, or you can write mu21. 2 with respect to 1 is represented by N21 or mu21 is given by speed of light in medium 1 divided by speed of light in medium 2. So V1 by V2. If medium 1 is vacuum or air, then the refractive index of medium 2 with respect to vacuum is known as absolute refractive index. If one of them is vacuum or air, then the medium refractive index of medium 2 will be the absolute refractive index of the medium. Okay. So if this is the speed of light in air or vacuum, we know what it is. It is speed of light. And the speed of light in the medium, the C by V, speed of light in vacuum, and the speed of light in the medium is the absolute refractive index. C is speed of light, V is speed of light in the medium, and N sub m, or you can call it as mu m also, is the refractive index of the medium. Refraction by spherical lenses. So lenses are defined as transparent materials, see-through materials, which are bounded by two surfaces. If you see mirror, one surface, here two surfaces, bounded by two surfaces, out of which one or both can be spherical. Both can be convex, both can be concave, or one can be concave, convex, or other can be plane. So when both of the two spherical surfaces, they bulge outwards like this. This is bulging outward, this is also bulging outward. This kind of lens is known as convex lens. They converge the ray. They will always converge the ray. When the two spherical surface bulge inwards, so how they bulge inwards? They bulge inwards like this. They bulge inward like this. They are known as concave lens. And these are known as diverging lens. That is, they will diverge the ray. So the center of these spherical mirrors is known as the center of curvature, or we will represent it by C. An imaginary line which is passing through the center of curvature of a lens will be known as principal axis, like this. This will be known as a principal axis. The center point is known as optical center. This is optical center. The effective diameter of the lens is known as aperture. So there will be diameter of this, because this is a circular part. This is also a circular part. So there will be a effective diameter, and we'll know it as the aperture. So how does this image form by lenses? Their nature, relative size, position. An image formed by the convex lens. This is convex lens. First, let us see how this is happening. The rules of drawing the ray diagram are like this, because these we are now trying to know the image formation in lenses. This is convex and this is concave. So see, a ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis, this is principal axis. If a ray is parallel, it will pass through the principal focus. There are two focus. For this curved region, this is F2. For this one, this is F1. Again, for this also, for this one, this is F1. For this one, this is F2. So whenever there is a parallel ray, they are going to, this will be diverging, and if we extend it, it will appear that it is actually coming from F1. A ray which is passing through the focus, principal focus, this will emerge parallel to the principal axis after refraction from the convex lens. How? See, a ray which is coming from the F1, when it meets the lens, this will get parallel to the principal axis. Again, if a ray is coming here and it is, if you extend it, then it is appearing to come from the F2, that is the principal focus, it will become parallel to the principal axis. A light ray which is passing through optical center will emerge out without any deviation. So if a light ray is coming and it is passing through the optical center, there will be no change. It will go straight, both the cases. How are the image formed by convex lens for various position of the object? If the object is at infinity, then the rays will be all straight, and we know they will all be converging at the principal focus. If the object is beyond 2f, if this is f1 and this is 2f1, then one will go straight, it will pass through focus, one will directly pass through the center. So when they intersect, this is the image being formed. The object which is beyond 2f, beyond here we have taken it. The object is at 2f, that is, if this is f1 and this is 2f, so object is at 2f. Aperture distance, then what will happen? One will go like this, pass through focus, one will pass directly from the center. This is the image, object at 2f. How about between 2f and f? One will pass through like this, and this is going to pass through the focus. So this will be a larger image, an inverted image. If the object is exactly at F, at focus, then one will go like this from F2, one will pass through and they will never meet. So the image will be formed at infinity. When the object is less than F, you are putting the object between the pole, or you can say center, and F. Then one will go like this, pass through F2, one will go like this, pass through center. So if we have to extend them like this, if we extend them, the image will be formed here. Okay. The image being formed by concave lenses, if it is coming from infinity or infinity, then they will diverge, and if we connect them, it appears to come from F1. So here the image will be formed. If you place it between F1 and 2F1, the object, this ray will be diverging and this will go straight. So this diverging ray will be passing through focus. So this interaction or this intersection, this is the image. So let me just give you a brief idea. The position of the object, if it is at infinity for a convex lens, the position of object is F2, the image will be highly diminished, real and inverted. If it is beyond 2F1, then the image will be between F2 and 2F2 and it will be diminished, real and inverted. At 2F1, again at 2F2 only the image will be formed, it will be of the same size, real and inverted. Between F1 and F2, it is beyond 2F2 enlarged, highly enlarged and real and inverted. At focus, F1 means the image will be formed at infinity. This we are talking about convex lens. It should be infinitely large, real and inverted. Between F1 and the optical center O, then it will be formed on the same side of the image and it will be enlarged and virtually erect. So this is how the images are being formed in concave lens. Sign convention for spherical lens. So sign convention, these are used for spherical lenses, spherical mirrors. But the focal length of the convex lens is positive and that of concave lens. What I am trying to say here is that the sign convention of the spherical lenses will be almost similar to the spherical mirrors. That is, the concave and convex mirrors. There is a difference. The focal length of the convex lens will be taken as positive and the concave lens will be taken as negative. What is the lens formula and magnification? The lens formula is given by 1 by f will be equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. U is the object distance from the center and v is the image distance, f is the focal length. Then the ratio of the height of the image to the height of the object is known as the magnification. Magnification represented by M and it is equal to V by U, this by this. Power of a lens. The degree of convergence or divergence of light rays, we express it in terms of power. So the reciprocal of focal length is what? Is the power. If f is the focal length, the power will be reciprocal of this focal length. It is represented by p. P is given by 1 by f. The SI unit is diopter, represented by d. So the power of concave lens is negative and power of concave lens is positive.